Hello my dear students, in this video I'm going to talk about how to solve the system of linear equations using elementary row operations. Let's consider the system of two linear equations in two unknowns. Let's consider x1 minus 2x2 is equals to minus 1, minus x1 plus 3x2 is equals to 3. We have already discussed this system of linear equations in the previous video, where we tried to solve the system of linear equations using simultaneous solution procedure and graphical procedure. In the simultaneous solution procedure, we found the value of x1 from first equation in terms of the other variable x2, substituting that value of x1 in terms of x2 into the second equation to obtain the value of x2, and then substituting the value of x2 back to first equation to get the value of x1. And we found out that the solution of this system of linear equation is x1 is equals to 3 and x2 is equals to 2. Because when you substitute these values into these equations, those values satisfies these equations simultaneously. We also used graphical method to find the solution, and we found that the graph of these two linear equations, which are straight lines, are crossing each other at this point 3, 2. Hence, this system is consistent with a unique solution. Here we try to find the solution of this system using elementary row operations. We have already discussed about the basics of elementary row operation in the previous video. If you have not watched that video, you can click the I button on the screen now to watch that video. I'm also sharing the link in the description box. You can watch it from there as well. So first of all, in order to solve using elementary row operation, we need to write this system of linear equation into the matrix form, because we need an augmented matrix. So writing this equation in the matrix form as (1, -2, -1, 3), (x1, x2) is equals to -1, 3. I have a separate video about how to write the system of linear equations into the matrix form. You can watch that video by clicking the I button on the screen now. The augmented matrix of this system of linear equation is now written as (1, -2, -1, 3), (-1, 3). The basic idea of the solution of the system of linear equation is that we want to find the value of x1 from first equation and value of x2 from the second equation. So if we are able to make the coefficient of x2 as 0, then the value of x1 can be found straight away. And if the coefficient of the x1 in the second equation can be made 0, then the value of x2 can be found from the second equation straight away. So here we will work on the augmented matrix, apply elementary row operations on this matrix so that the coefficient of the second variable is 0, means we will make this -2 0, and the coefficient of x1 in the second equation 0, it means we will try to make this -1 0 by applying elementary row operations. I want to mention that whenever you are applying elementary row operations on the matrices, you have to work in the columns. That is more convenient than working on the rows. So let's work on the first column. We need the coefficient of x1 as 1, and we need the coefficient of the x1 in the second equation as 0. Need the coefficient of the x1 in the first equation as 1, and the coefficient of the x1 in the second equation 0. So in order to make this -1 0, if I add this 1 with this -1, I will get 0. So I will get a row equivalent augmented matrix by applying the elementary row operation R2 plus R1. It means that I want to replace R2 by the sum of itself and R1. So R1 will remain same. I will write down R1 first and then replacing R2 by the sum of R2 and R1. So that will be minus 1 plus 1, that will be 0. 3 minus 2, that becomes 1. 3 minus 1 becomes 2. Now our first column is fine. That is very much okay. Okay, now let's work in the second column. Okay, we will get another row equivalent matrix by applying the elementary row operation. What we want to do, we want to make the coefficient of x2 in the second equation 1, and we want to make the coefficient of x2 in the first equation 0. So in order to make here, we already have the coefficient of x2 in the second equation as 1. So we need to make minus 2 0, because that is the coefficient of x2 in the first equation. In order to make this minus 2 0, I need plus 2 to add into this minus 2 to make it 0. How we can get plus 2? We can multiply this 1 with positive 2 and add that result into this first row. So we will apply the elementary row operation R1, which is minus 2 here, and then adding 2 times R2. Now we are replacing R1, so R2 will remain same. R1 plus 2 times R2, so 1 plus 2 times 0, there will be 1, minus 2 plus 2 times 1, that would be 0, minus 1 plus 2 times 2 would be 4, so minus 1 plus 4 becomes 3. Now, as I told you, that the augmented matrix, this augmented matrix is basically equivalent to 1 minus 2 minus 1, so that would be x1, 1 times x1 plus minus 2 times x2 is equals to minus 1, and the second row would be minus 1 times x1 plus 3 times x2 is equals to 3. Hence, if we simplify this, we just write down this equation as we just write down as this one as x1 minus, sorry, this should be minus here. So this should be x1 minus 2 x2 is equals to minus 1. This would be x1 minus x1 plus 3 x2 is equals to 3. It means that if we want to find the equivalent system of linear equations equivalent to this augmented matrix, that can be written as 1 into x1 plus 0 into x2 is equals to 3, 0 into x1 plus 1 into x2, here it would be also 1 into x1 is equals to 2. So when we simplify this system of linear equations, we will get x1 plus 0 is equals to 3, 0 plus x2 is equals to 2. And when we simplify this, we will get x1 is equals to 3 and x2 is equals to 2, which is basically the solution which we obtained using simultaneous solution and graphical method. So this is how we apply a sequence of elementary row operations on the augmented matrix obtained from the given system of linear equations to reduce it to the form where the coefficient of the first variable in the first equation is 1 all other coefficients are zero. Similarly, the coefficient of the second variable in the second equation is 1, all other coefficients are 0. Similarly, if we have 3 equations, then the coefficient of the third variable in the third equation should be 1, all other coefficients are 0. Then the solution can be found by just writing down the equivalent system of linear equations equivalent to that augmented matrix and then finding the value of x1, x2 and x3. The most important thing which you have to note here that whenever you are applying elementary row operations, you have to work in the columns. So first of all, you have to work on the first column, then second column, then third column, then there will be no chance to make any mistake. If you have any question regarding this video, you may ask me in the comment section. I will try my best to resolve your queries. And if you like this video, hit the like button, subscribe to my channel for more useful videos. Thank you.